a community to be Muslim and also to give them a chance to have a go at Laylatul Qadr. Even the best human being, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to wish for it. By the way, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given Laylatul Qadr as a gift. It was given to this ummah as a gift. The story is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knowing through the Prophet's life, he saw that some of the communities before Muslim, they lived for a long time. And we all know the story of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, before him Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, they lived for hundreds and hundreds of years. More than 1,000 years, the lifespan. So 300 years with a young boy. So when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw that, and he came across somebody that if you add their ibadah, if you add our ibadah, if you live for 70 years, let's just assume you live for 70 years, take away the first 10 years, it's gone. Because the first 10 years you're still learning, you're a child, you're not accountable. You live for 60 years. How many years do we sleep? Third of our life, minimum. The third, 8 hours a day, take away another 20 years sleep. You left with 40 years. Then you have 8 hours at work or at study. Do the math. Another 20 years gone. So, maximum. If you're the best of the best of the best, you will be worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala half the time that you're free, which is 10 years. That's it. It's not 70 years of ibadah, it's not 80 years, no. If you add them all up, inshallah, will be 10 years. So that made the Prophet ﷺ so concerned. He didn't say anything, but he was concerned, how come my ummah will not achieve as the previous nation? If you add somebody who lived 1,000 years, third of it sleep, third of it work, he's still got 300 years. Then you take half of it, 150 years. So the Prophet ﷺ came across an example from the previous nation, somebody that fasted and did jihad and did Qiyamul Layl for 83 years. If you add his ibadah, which was the perfect ibadah, cream, he does the best thing during the day and the best thing during the night. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Laylatul Qadr. For the sake of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I've given you a night. If your ummah catch it, they will get more reward than somebody lived for 1,000 years before. It is starting tonight. Every night is worth 30,000 nights. Every rak'ah, every subhanallah, every sajda, every ayah, every salam alaikum, every smile, it's worth 30,000 of it. The Prophet said, "Man hurima ajraha faqad hurim." Whoever misses Laylatul Qadr is absolutely missed something massive, something very valuable. What is more valuable than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran? Laylatul Qadr. Imagine this, Allah Himself saying, this night is a night of honor. It's a night of a high status. It's a night of nobility. It's a night. This what? تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا. The angels take permission from Allah to come and witness the Muslim. The angels can't wait. Oh Allah, we want to see. Because standing in line is exactly the same way the angels stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet ﷺ in Salah, he used to say, أَلَا تَصْطَفُونَ كَمَا تَصْطَفُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Make your line like the angels make the lines. So the angel on that night, they ask permission, بِإِذْنَا رَبِّهِمْ. And Allah give them permission to come and witness. Some human being leaving their sleep, leaving their comfort, leaving their work, sometime to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to stand and cry, to stand and say, thank you, Ya Allah, to stand and say, you know, forgive me, Allah. Not only the angel, with Jibreel himself. This is, you can't describe this. Brothers, Jibreel is the closest creation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the most senior of all angels. He is near Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hadith say, if Allah loves somebody, he tells Jibreel. If Allah loves somebody, he says, Jibreel, I love so and so. You know what? That is automatically makes Jibreel fall in love with you. Jibreel himself loves that person. Not only that, he will go unto the angels, the army of angels, and announce to them, Inna Allah ta'ala yuhibbu fulanan fa'ahibbu. He will command the angels, Allah loves so and so. All of you love him. What does that mean? They will make dua for you non-stop. They can't wait for you to make it to Jannah, so they can serve you. As the ayah says, وَالْمَلَائِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ. The angels will be coming from every door. Say what? Salamun alaykum. Peace, brothers. How are you? Tibtum, you are the pure. You are the good ones. You controlled your emotion. He controlled your desires. He controls your potential to make wrong. And you made good. Well done. Jibreel himself come in that night. Not just staying up there and Allah tell him, I love. No. He comes to earth and he will say, Salamun hiya hatta matla' al-fajr. He will be visiting every home that have somebody standing, every masjid that have somebody standing, every masjid that somebody sitting doing Quran or dhikr or cooking or cleaning or something for Allah, Jibreel will come and say salam. Do you know what this means? Jibreel came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said to him, Khadija is coming. Please send my salam to Khadija. We are raising to the rank of one of the perfect human being. The Prophet said, only four women reached perfection. One of them is Khadija. For Jibreel to say salam, he doesn't say salam to anybody. And for Allah to give us that opportunity to have a go at earning that, is just absolutely incredible. That we need to say, thank you Allah to make us live to this time. Thank you Allah to make us from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Thank you Allah to make us witness the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Jibreel come and he says salam. Imagine this, Jibreel will only come to the honored people. He comes to prophets. He comes with the VIP messages. He doesn't come for anything else. He doesn't come for death or birth or destruction of nation or creation of galaxy. No. This is too small job for him. He comes with a message from Allah only. He is a ruh, I mean, he just doesn't come for anything else. So coming on that night, wallahi, think about it. It is beyond description. It's beyond description. It's beyond nobility and status and ranks. If Jibreel comes to this earth and see you praying, or see you reading Quran, or seeing you helping Muslim, or seeing you remembering Allah, you are the winners of that year. You are the winner of that year. Jibreel came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said salam to Aisha. Jibreel came to all the prophets. He came to the Prophet Ibrahim. He came to the Prophet Luke. He came to all the messengers. So to come to us, to the Muslim Ummah in this time, it's a ni'mah, it's a blessing, it's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we need to be exactly like the horse at the end of the race. This is the end of Ramadan. This is the end of Ramadan. What do the horses do when they can see the finish line? They just give it everything. And that's what the Muslim's supposed to be. That's what we're supposed to be giving now. Giving it everything. Have a go at every good deed you can. Reading Quran, making dua, crying. We must cry this night. Wallahi, we must cry this night. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِن لَمْ تَبْكُوا فَتَبَاكُوا. Force yourself to cry with joy and cry and say, Ya Allah, thank you for Ramadan. Ya Allah, thank you. Ya Allah, soften my heart so I can thank you more than enough. Because that is the time we need it. That is the time we need to cry to Allah and say, Ya Allah, we are not entitled to this. We are sinners. We have so many mistakes. Thank you for making us witness Ramadan. Thank you for having a community that loves us and supports us. Thank you for making us Muslim. Thank you for giving us a straight path. That is the time, is Laylatul Qadr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you make wudu, listen to this, if you make wudu at home and come to the masjid to pray, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَتَبَشْبَشْ. يَتَبَشْبَشْ, it's like the biggest happiness that your family will have when you're away from them and return home. Again, Allah's happy with us spending half an hour to go to the masjid. More than a family that have a loved one that he's away from them and they can't wait for him to return. Imagine your mom and dad, brother and sister, when you go home, the happiness they have. Allah is more happy than this family with their absent one. Just for us coming to the masjid. And as I said yesterday, praying Isha, the angel rides half the night. You pray Fajr, the angel rides the whole night in Qiyam. So you're catching Laylat al-Qadr 100% if you look after these two. Isha and Fajr with Jama'ah in the masjid. There is bonus, praying with the Imam till he leaves, we only spend 1 hour. The angels don't write 1 hour, they write the whole night. Did you know that? The Prophet ﷺ said, "Man salla ma'al imam hatta yansarf, kutiba lahu qiyam layla." The whole night qiyam is written for you. So there is so many, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, great opportunity for us to achieve what we can this night. So please, we need to help each other, encourage, make dua for each other. We'll catch Laylatul Qadr. Make dua for each other that Allah will reward us and bless us with Laylatul Qadr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us Laylatul Qadr.